Now, after understanding of the first law of thermodynamics, there are two processes which are important and used in further education also. If you understand this process, then you can know what is happening in next some articles. So, in which first is isothermal process. Now here isothermal process, with the name you can understand that iso means same and thermal means that is the heat energy. So a process in which the heat energy will be same or temperature will be same throughout the process, that is called as isothermal process. Now in your board book, the definition is written such as a process in which temperature of the system is kept fixed throughout is called an isothermal process. So when a process is going on, it means that you can give the energy of any type. Here we are using the energy of the heat energy. So the process is such that the temperature of the system remains constant throughout the process. That means the pressure may be changed, volume may be changed, mass may be changed, etc. Because you know PV is equal to RT, that is the ideal gas equation in which P is the pressure, V is the volume and T is the temperature of the gas, of the gaseous system, where R is the gas constant. So if there is temperature constant, that means there may be change in pressure and volume. So what may be the changes in the pressure and volume, and what is the relation between this isothermal process, between the, what is the relation between the pressure and volume? So as from the ideal gas equation, we know that PV is equal to constant. As T is constant, R is gas constant. So you can here also write from this definition, PV is equal to constant. So we can also write this equation as P is inversely proportional to the volume of a gas. P is directly proportional to 1 upon V, or you can say P is inversely proportional to volume of a gas, where capital T is the temperature of a gas. It is constant throughout the system. So if you remember that this PV is equal to constant, in which pressure of a gas is inversely proportional to the volume of a gas, when the temperature is constant, it is nothing but Boyle's law. As you have studied the Boyle's law, Charles' law, then this is the Boyle's law. At T is constant, pressure is inversely proportional to volume. So this process is called as isothermal process. Then next is, this isothermal process, it is a very slow process because temperature is constant, so there is change in the pressure, volume, and it will be very slow process. Now another is process that is called as adiabatic process. In adiabatic process, here is the system is, it is insulated from the surrounding. This system is the separate from the surrounding, As I have already told you, the system is isolated by the boundaries around the system. So here the system is insulated from the surroundings and there is no absorption of heat and there is no transfer of heat or there is no release of the heat. So the heat absorption and release of the heat energy, there it is equal to zero. So it means that there is no heat exchange, heat absorption, and it is not release the heat. So for this adiabatic process, this is the fast adiabatic process, because here there is no the exchange of the heat energy. For an adiabatic process, we can write this ideal gas equation, PV to the power gamma is equal to constant. So PV is equal to gamma is equal to constant. This term gamma is new for us, as here is also PV is equal to constant for ideal gas equation. But here is PV of the power gamma is equal to constant. So what is the gamma? So gamma is nothing but it is the ratio of the specific heat at constant pressure and at constant volume, Cp and Cv, you know well. So gamma is equal to Cp upon Cv, that is the ratio of the specific heats at constant pressure and at constant volume. Now in this process, here we will consider the two situations. If initially we will consider that the system having the pressure P1 and the volume V1 of the power gamma, and after some time we will get pressure also change, that is P2, or pressure and volume is also change, that is V2. Or if both are with respect to this gamma are equal, if you will write only P1 V1 is equal to P2 V2 is equal to constant, then that is not correct one. Here you have to write of the specific heat P1 V1 of the gamma is equal to P2 V2 of the ratio gamma, that will be equal to constant. Now here, what is the work done by the system, that also you can measure from the formula. But how we will get the formula, we will see in very short time. As the system is here, and this system, when the heat is supplied, so when the heat is supplied, this system, here the energy, internal energy is increases, and for gas, here is the kinetic energy increases. So now due to the kinetic energy, here work is done. Now we know the formula for the work done. Work done, it is equal to force into displacement. I think in chemistry you can have studied that the example of the piston. So here is some gas and So if initially consider that it is the air gas. So this will be the gas. So at that time pressure is different and here volume is also different. So force is acting. After acting the force, this will be come to that point. So here will be this is displacement. So F into displacement, force into displacement, we can write here ds. Now we can convert this formula, that is pressure into volume. So what is the formula for the pressure? As we know, P is equal to F upon A. So we can also write it is F is equal to P into A. So here we can write P into A into delta S. Or it will be, we will write here length. So here the P and area into length. Area into length is volume. So we can write here it is volume delta V, where this is the work done dW. So with the help of this formula we can obtain the work done by the system. Or it is pressure may be same, or on different situation the pressure may be different and there will be change in the volume. Due to work done the volume may be changed, it will may be increases or the volume may be decreases. It is depends upon the situation, but here the work is done by the system. Due to that there will be the change in the volume. So it is the formula, with the help of that we can obtain what will be the work done by the system on the surrounding and due to that what will be the change in the system. Now after first law, here is the second law of thermodynamics. And second law of thermodynamics that gives a important conclusion. When practically first law of thermodynamics is implemented, so we will get that one type of the energy, that is the mechanical work energy, mechanical work, it can be converted completely into heat. If you have performed any work, then that work can be completely converted into heat. We get heat from it. But the main point is here that heat cannot be completely converted into mechanical work. As we eat anything, then we will get the heat energy from that. But that heat energy cannot be totally converted into our mechanical work, but some amount of the energy that will be used for the wastage. For that we have to go toilet. So here is the important point we have to understand, that mechanical work, if you perform mechanical work, that can be converted into completely into the heat. But heat energy is given to any body or to any machine, then this mechanical work that is cannot converted completely. Heat cannot be completely converted into mechanical work. It means that work and heat, they are not equivalent. If you will give the work or if you will give the heat energy, then total heat energy cannot be converted into the work. This is the conclusion of the second law of the thermodynamics, or we can also called as it is the second law of thermodynamics, in which or with the help of this second law of thermodynamics and first law of thermodynamics also, now we can understand how the heat engine is work or refrigerator is also work. Now we will see the heat engine, and heat engine, it is works in the cyclic process, means it perform the work again and again, same process. And here the second law of thermodynamics is applied in this heat engine. So here it takes the heat energy from the bodies which is at a higher temperature. In a rig diagram here you see that this is called reservoir. Reservoir means it is the house of any temp, if consider anything that is having any very large amount. If we consider that there is a sea, samudra, in which there is a large amount of the water. If we take 2 or 3 buckets or 1 ton of the water, then there is no change in that level of the water. So similarly here, if some amount of the heat energy is taken from this reservoir, then there will be no change in the temperature of this reservoir. For example, if in this room we will consider here it is 32 degree Celsius temperature, and a bike comes and goes from here with emitting the some vapor from it, and due to that, that also have a heat energy, but due to that temperature of the heat, it is so small that it cannot affect the temperature of the room, and the temperature of the room remains same. So here now we will here see that engine that is having a working substance, we say it is a working substance. So from reservoir which is having a very high temperature, we get some amount of the heat energy. After getting some amount of heat energy, that is Q1, it will be this energy used by the working substance to perform the work on the surrounding. Here we can also write here Q1 is heat absorbed by the system. So this is acting as the system and work done on the environment. So this heat energy will be used to perform the work. So this energy will be, it will be convert part of it to the mechanical work, and remaining body is at lower temperature. So this heat energy, it will be used by the system, and some amount of heat that will be rejected to the sink, that is of no use. It means that the total amount of heat does not used by this system to perform the work, but some amount of heat is rejected to the sink. So this process is going in a cyclic manner, and it will be for the same purpose, it will be perform the work by the heat engine. Now Mathematically, we will now want to what is the efficiency of the heat engine. On the basis of heat in efficiency of heat engine, we can select that heat engine. So for that, as the efficiency having the symbol this eta, and the formula for that is work done by the upon the amount of heat that will be from received from the reservoir. This is Q1. So eta is equal to W upon Q1, and according to the thermodynamic first law, we can write here this work done. This work done is nothing but difference between Q1 and Q2. We can also write here Q1 is equal to W plus Q2. For in the same manner of that first law, we can also write this. It is Q1 is given, some amount of it is in the work done, and another amount is goes to the sink. But we can also write this W is equal to Q1 minus Q2. Now we will substitute this value in equation 1, that is eta is equal to W upon Q1. So here eta is equal to, instead of W, we can write here Q1 minus Q2, this upon Q1. If we split it, this equation, Q1 upon Q1 minus Q2 upon Q1. So here 1 minus Q2 upon Q1, that we will get the formula. That is of the efficiency of a heat engine. Now if we will consider, ideally we want that the efficiency of this any heat engine should be 1, that is 100% performance is takes place. But for that we have to Q2 is equal to 0. If Q2 is equal to 0, whole term becomes 0, and the answer will be eta is equal to 1. But in Reg diagram you see here that this heat amount of heat energy Q1, it will, when gives to the system, it will perform the work, but some amount of heat goes to the sink, some amount of the heat is rejected or does not used by this system or the heat engine. So practically there is no any heat engine that having the efficiency that is equal to 1. It is about the heat engine.
Good morning students. In kinetic theory of gases and radiation, in previous class we have studied about the thermodynamics, laws of thermodynamics, heat engine, refrigerators, etc. Now the next article is absorption, reflection and transmission of heat radiation. So we will here consider capital Q is the total radiant energy incident upon the surface of the any body. If we will consider there is any body, and here is the radiant energy is incident. So here is the capital Q that is incident on this body. So some amount of this radiant energy, it will be absorbed. So we can write here it is absorbed. Then some will be transmitted. It will be transmitted. And some will be reflected. This will be reflected. So in the similar way, we will study that when the total radiant energy incident upon the surface of the body, that is capital Q, some part of the body is absorbed, that is denoted by QA. Some part of the body is reflected, that is QR. And some part of the body is transmitted, that is denoted by QT. So after addition of these three, QA plus QR plus QT, that is equal to Q. So we will say it is equation number one. Now after that, coefficient of absorption. It means that when the body, on body, when the heat radiant energy is incident, and the how much of the radiant energy is absorbed, the ratio of these two quantity is called as coefficient of a absorption. So first we will take the quantity of the absorbed radiant energy and then incident radiant energy. So here you see here the ratio of quantity of radiant energy absorbed. First we will take the quantity of the radiant energy absorbed by the body in a given time to the quantity of the radiant energy incident on the body, that is Q. So we can also write this small a, that is denoted by the, that is denoted coefficient of absorption. Coefficient of absorption is denoted by small a. That is equal to radiant energy absorbed upon radiant energy incident, and that is small a, it is equal to QA upon Q. This is the formula of the coefficient of absorption. Now the which bodies are good absorbers? So the black surfaces of the bodies, they are good absorbers of the radiant heat. Next we will see about the black body and how they absorb the maximum radiant energy. If for a perfectly black body, here you see that A is equal to 1, whereas for ordinary bodies it will be less than 1, means all the radiant energy is not absorbed by the body. Then after that, the second is coefficient of reflection. As in figure you see that when a ray of incident amount of radiant energy, some part is reflected. So with the help of that we will see coefficient of reflection, whereas the ratio of the quantity of radiant energy reflected by the body, that is denoted by QR in a given time, to the quantity of radiant energy incident on the body. Incident on the body is denoted by capital Q in the same time. This is in the given time, in the same time means same time. So the relation will be small r is equal to, that is the coefficient of reflection, it is equal to QR upon Q. We can say here it is equation number 3. So we say it is equation number 3. So that is coefficient of absorption and coefficient of reflection. Now we will see the coefficient of transmission.
We have to solve the problems that temperature will be given. So that temperature will be written in this symbols. So T2 upon T1 minus T2, it this formula we will take there. So here the process of this refrigerators and heat engine, it is irreversible. There is no reverse of the process. So it is about the refrigerators, and now we will take some MCQs on this thermodynamics first law, second law, and then refrigerator, heat engine, etc.